Hello coders, I welcome you all. In this video, we are going to revise the CI/CD pipeline using a question and answer format. The main purpose of this video is to help you revisit the basics of the CI/CD pipeline in the future. So this is the format I have created for the discussion. I will present the question along with four possible options that you can see here. First, I will read the question and the options. After that, you can pause the video and try to find the correct answer. Then we will discuss the answer. So let's get started. So this is our question number one. What is continuous integration? Option A, manual integration of code into a shared repository. B, automated process of integrating code changes to a shared repository. C, a strategy to merge code during the release cycle. And D, a method to test code after deployment. Please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. As I said, we will discuss it in detail. I hope you found the correct option, right? The correct answer here is option B, automated process of integrating code changes to a shared repository. Let's discuss the answer. What is CI? CI stands for continuous integration. Continuous integration is a software development practice where developers regularly merge their code changes into a central repository, usually multiple times a day. Each merge triggers an automated process that builds and tests the code to ensure it integrates smoothly without breaking the main project. Main project, which is available inside main repository on GitHub, right? CI helps catch integration issues early, maintain code quality, and speed up development cycle. How continuous integration works? So as we discussed, continuous integration is a practice where developers frequently commit their code to a shared repository. Every time new code is committed, an automated system runs to build the code, perform tests, and check for issues. Here you can understand with CI, we are automating tasks that would normally require human effort. This is helpful because many developers work together and it is not possible for a human to handle everything, especially since they commit at different times and multiple times a day. So we are setting up an automated system that runs to build the code, perform test, and check for issues whenever developers commit their code to a shared repository. So this ensures that any problems are identified early, allowing developers to fix them quickly. The goal is to keep the code base stable, means our central repository stable and up to date, making software development faster and more reliable. The correct answer here is option B, automated process of integrating code changes to a shared repository. Now let's move to our question number two. Here is our question number two. What is continuous deployment? Option A, a process of manually deploying code to production after extensive testing. B, a method of integrating code changes to a local environment. C, a practice of automatically deploying code changes to production after passing test. And D, a technique for managing version control. Again, please pause the video and try to answer the question. After that, we will discuss it. So here, correct option is option C, a practice of automatically deploying code changes to production after passing test. So please remember, continuous deployment automates the process of deploying code changes to production without the need for manual intervention, ensuring that updates are delivered to users quickly and consistently, right? So here, option C is the correct answer for this question. What is continuous deployment? A practice of automatically deploying code changes to production after passing test. Hope all of you are clear with this. Now let's move to our question number three. So here is our question number three. In GitHub Actions, what is a job? Option A, a collection of workflows. Option B, an individual task within a workflow that can be run independently. C, a task to check for errors in the code. D, a tool for managing version control. Again, please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. After that, we will discuss it in detail. So here, correct answer is option B, an individual task within a workflow that can be run independently. Let me show you this in the VS code. Here you can see in the last video of CI/CD pipeline, we have created these jobs that you can see here. This is our first job with name lint to check linting errors. After that, we have created our second job, unit test, that will perform unit testing, right? In GitHub Actions, jobs are individual tasks within a workflow that can run independently, that you can see here. We have created this particular workflow with name lint.yaml. And these are our jobs, our first job, and this is our second job. So as I said, in GitHub Actions, jobs are individual tasks within a workflow that you can see that can run independently. Please remember, by default, these jobs are run concurrently, means in parallel, which speed ups the overall workflow. But please remember, jobs can also be configured to depend on each other if needed, ensuring they run in a specific order, right? That also we have done with this particular parameter needs, right? This unit test needs lint. So in this example, the unit testing job requires the linting job to be completed first. Only if the linting job is successfully executed, means our first job is successfully executed, then only the unit testing job will start. Here we want our jobs run sequentially. That also we can do, right? But as we discussed, by default, these jobs run concurrently in parallel, right? But also we can do like this as well. So as you can see, jobs can also be configured to depend on each other if needed, that you can see here, ensuring they run in specific order. First, this job, lint, then after unit test will be executed here. I hope this explanation is clear to everyone. So that's why this is the correct option. Option B, an individual task within a workflow that can be run independently, which we can call as a job in GitHub Actions. Let's move to our question number 4. So this is our question number 4. What are steps in a GitHub Actions job? Option A, independent task that can run concurrently. Option B, a collection of jobs that can run together. Option C, individual task executed in sequence within a job. Option D, actions that trigger a workflow to start. Again, please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. After that, we will discuss it in detail. So here, correct answer is option C, individual task executed in sequence within a job. Again, let's move to VS code. You can see, as we discussed, we have two jobs. First, with name lint, and second, with name unit-test. And here you can see different steps for job 1 and different steps for job 2. So please remember, in GitHub Actions, steps are individual tasks that can run one after another within a job. Each step can run commands or use actions, and they are executed in order they are defined, that you can see here. In this first job, we have 4 steps: check out code, set up Python, install dependencies, and run flag 8. Same 3 steps in job 2: code checkout, set up Python, and run unit test. In GitHub Actions, steps are individual tasks that run one after the other within a job, that you can see here, within a job. Hope all of you are clear with this. So that's why this is the answer. Steps are individual tasks executed in sequence within a job. Now let's move on. This is our question number 5. What file extension is used for GitHub Actions workflow files? Option A, .git. Option B, .yaml. Option C, .yml. And option D, both B and C. So please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. After that, we will discuss it in detail. So correct answer here is option D, both B and C. So these both .yaml and .yml are valid extensions four CI configuration files. Let me show you this. Let's move to VS. Here you can see CI configuration file with this particular name, lint.yaml with extension YAML. But also we can use YML extension as well. So these both extensions are valid for CI configuration files, .yaml or .yml. Hope all of you are clear with this. So here is the answer, both B and C. So now let's move on. Here is our question number 6. Which of the following best describes a GitHub Actions runner? Option A, a server that hosts and executes workflows triggered by GitHub events. Option B, a command line tool used to commit code to a repository. Option C, a graphical interface for managing repositories. And option D, a service that deploys code to production environments. Again, please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. After that, we will discuss it in detail. So here, correct answer is option A, a server that hosts and executes workflows triggered by GitHub events. So now let's discuss it in detail. This is our main code base where the core project resides. Over here, we have a developer, and here is the assistant and runner space for the assistant. As the developer, you provide a set of tasks for the assistant to perform after the trigger has occurred. The tasks listed in the workflow by the developer are performed on the assistant's system, which is called as a runner. You can think of the runner as a virtual machine where assistant executes all the steps provided in the workflow. So that's why this is the answer. Hope all of you are clear with the answer. A runner is a server that hosts and executes workflows triggered by GitHub events. Now let's move on to our question number 7. So here is our question number 7. How do you define a workflow in GitHub Actions? Option A, by creating a .workflow file in the repository. Option B, by creating a .git workflow file in the .github folder. Option C, by creating a .yaml file in the .github/workflows directory. Option D, by using the git workflow command in the terminal. Again, please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. After that, we will discuss it. So here, correct option is option C, by creating a .yaml file in the .github/workflows directory. Let me show you this. Let's jump to VS Code. You can see this is our CI configuration file that we have created in this folder, .github/workflows, that you can see, right? That's why this is the correct answer, by creating a .yaml file in the .github/workflows directory, that you can see here, .github/workflows directory, right? Inside that, we have created CI configuration file for GitHub Actions. Now let's move on. Now let's move to our question number 8. So here is our question number 8. How can you trigger a GitHub Actions workflow? Option A, by configuring trigger events like push, pull request, or schedule. Option B, by committing a file to a local branch. Option C, by renaming the repository. And option D, creating a new repository. Again, please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. So here, correct answer is option A, by configuring trigger events like push, pull request, or schedule. Using these events, we can trigger a GitHub Actions workflow. Let me show you this. Let's move to VS Code. Here you can see on push and pull request. So here, our workflow will be triggered on push and pull request on master branch, that you can see here, right? So the developer will decide the trigger, such as on a push, pull request, or schedule time. And when this trigger occurs, the assistant will execute the workflow. In our case, our virtual assistant is GitHub Actions. Hope all of you are clear with this, right? So that's why this is the answer. We can trigger a GitHub Actions workflow by configuring trigger events like push, pull request, or schedule. Hope all of you are clear with this. Now let's move to our question number 9. So here is our question number 9. What is the difference between uses and run in GitHub actions? Option A. Uses is for running shell commands and run is for using pre-built actions. Option B. Uses is for using pre-built actions and run is for running shell commands or scripts. Option C. Uses triggers workflows and run is for manual execution. Option D. Uses runs test and run installs dependencies. Again, please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. After that, we will discuss it. So here, correct answer is option B. Uses is for using pre-built actions and run is for running shell commands or scripts. Let me show this. Let's jump to VS Code. Here you can see our created workflow. And here in the steps, we have used uses. And here we are using pre-built actions provided by GitHub that you can see. Here also uses. Again, here we are using pre-built action. And here you can see run. Here we are running shell commands or scripts that you can see. Hope all of you are clear with this, right? Uses is for using pre-built actions that you can see. And run is for running shell commands or scripts that you can see, right? Hope all of you are clear with this. That's why this is the correct answer. Uses is for using pre-built actions and run is for running shell commands or scripts. Now let's move on to our next question. Question number 10. So here is our question number 10. What is the purpose of using strategy metrics in GitHub actions? Option A. To run different versions of the same workflow for multiple operating systems or configurations. Option B. To execute the workflow in parallel on different branches. Option C. To allow manual selection of the workflow environment. And option D. To trigger workflows based on pull request changes. Again, please pause the video at this point and try to answer the question. After that, we will discuss it in detail. So here, the correct answer is option A. To run different versions of the same workflow for multiple operating systems or configurations. Let me show this. Let's jump to VS Code. As you can see here, we have used 3 operating systems and 3 Python versions in this strategy and metrics, right? So the metrics helps ensure that our code works across different environments without needing to manually configure and run each version separately, right? That you can see. So here we have used 3 operating systems and 3 versions of Python that we have done using this actions, strategy and metrics. Hope all of you are clear with this, right? So this is the answer. The purpose of strategy metrics is to run different versions of the same workflow for multiple operating systems or configurations. Hope all of you are clear with this. I hope you got basic understanding about CI/CD pipeline using GitHub actions. Hope you like this video. Please don't forget to subscribe this channel. If you like this video, smash that like button. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.